Welcome back, everyone, to some more Mass Effect 3. We gotta go fight more Cerberus forces. I assume we have fuel, yes. Cerberus fighter base. We are here. Aethon cluster. What's this Aethon cluster? Mid-Solarian counselor. Well, we're really heading here, but I want to check out what's going on at the Aethon cluster. I definitely do not remember that one. Maybe some of the things we're looking for are there. We have a few side missions to find various things. Aru! Aru! So the Aethon cluster consists of... wow. Isori, Aru, Nura, and Satu Ard. Alright. Alright, so it looks like this episode is going to consist of planet exploration instead. So, the planet Jack Sir. His name is Jack, but you call him Sir. Jack Sir features heavily in ancient Volus mythology and folklore since its bright white surface made it easy to chart in the night sky without the art of a telescope. Once the Volus developed advanced astronomical equipment, their scientists discovered that Jack Sir's luminosity was caused by a thick carbon monoxide cloud cover that had hidden the real face of the planet for millennia. Alright, hoping we find Irun, the Book of Planets thing that we need to find is on a Volus homeworld, I believe. Oh, here you go. Irun, the Volus homeworld, looks very similar to Earth, only a lot more land. It is a high-pressure, high-gravity planet that supports an ammonia-based ecology. This rare environment means that the Volus have been slow to colonize, as there are few planets that meet their habitation requirements. Most prefer to stay on Irun, working remotely via the extranet. The more adventurous don the clumsy but vital pressure suits and venture out to worlds and citadel space to make their fortunes. Oh my, there's a lot. Irun is remarkable for having done away with warfare as an institution of the state. Volus culture lacks the romantic view of war found in the galaxy's more aggressive species. Physical skirmishes between groups rarely last long and are almost always ended by social castigation. Bargaining agreements are harsh economic sanctions. Irun's cities tend to be built on fast trade routes rather than militarily defensible positions. This has left them vulnerable to husk attack now that the Reapers have overwhelmed the Turian fleets and begun a ground war on the planet. Citadel Travel Advisory. Irun's ammonia-based atmosphere is toxic to non-Volus lifeforms. Visitors to Irun must wear pressure suits at all times when traveling outside of environmentally controlled areas. So then wear like a Volus. Wish we could see what they really look like, though. Just a picture. They can take a picture of themselves without the suit on. Population 8.8 billion. Population estimates pre-invasion, of course. Capital is Lenos. Like Jay Leno. Alright, we're definitely gonna check that out. Let's look at this asteroid belt. See if there's anything hidden in here. Whoop! I heard that.
Signal confirmed.
So we got both. Reapers are somewhat alerted. 200 units of fuel. Didn't need. Full already. Kind of miss scanning for resources, even though it got a little, what do you call it? repetitive after a while. I know, I'm talking. Probe away. Dun 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 dun. Oh, artifacts, Book of Planets. Yay! Well, we found that. Did we return? I think we give it to the guy who's standing in front of the poster about Sanctuary. I wonder if we're going to find out more about this Sanctuary. Oh, I haven't finished with the, with 66% assets recovered. There's something else here. There's one more thing. So I'm just going to look around in here. And nothing there. Probably something on one of these other planets. Lossil. The first of the Aru system's three gas giants, Lossil is also the largest. Boasting over 96 moons, the planet's orbit bustled with hundreds of helium-3 extraction centers. Most of the work population lived on Lossil's orbital stations, which were so numerous they became an unofficial city chained together by taxi services and extended umbilical cords. The Reaper attack here has devastated the infrastructure, raining fragments down onto the gas giant. Those metal bastards. Chirk Sab. Named after a northern Arunian luck deity, Chirk Sab is overshadowed by the economy on Lossil and the scientific research on Doldit. The solar system's middle child, Chirk Sab, now has the only functioning helium-3 fuel apparatus in the system, as the Reapers have not yet struck there. The space around it is jammed with Volus ships trying to flee the system. What's... oh. Ice Giant? Oh, that's Doldit. Doldit's moons have long since been mined out, but they still hosted dozens of corporate-owned laboratories relocated there to avoid the environmental restrictions placed on research and development firms by Arun. Everything from weapon testing to cutting-edge biological research was outsourced to facilities orbiting Doldit. This made it an attractive target for the Reapers, who sent a small but powerful force to blow the facilities into scrap. Bunch of stand-up guys, let me tell you. Alright, I'm not sure where the other one would be. I'm gonna have to leave shortly. Hold up! Hope we can get away. Volus fabrication units. Is that one of the things I'm looking for? No. I'm looking for automated turret schematics, improved power grid, and heating unit stabilizers. Well, it's cool in any case. Get the hell out of here. Yay!
Faster than light jump successful.
Okay, 100%. Nice. Let's head to Nura. We find some fuel. Gorgon? Let's check the inside first. Lahu. Massive silicate-filled dust storms plague the surface of Lahu. In an odd partnership of commerce and science, high-rolling Volus casinos on Omakur entered a partnership with the scientific research teams whose observation satellites watch over Lahu. The casinos took bets on how long Lahu's storms would last and how high their wind speed might climb. Payouts made the rare Volus rich, with jackpot winners forming a small fraternal order. Oh my god, the Reapers have destroyed the satellites. Next is Omakur, mentioned. Omakur is a temperate garden world currently in its megafauna stage. The planet's nitrogen-oxygen atmosphere and dextro-amino acid-based life wasn't particularly attractive to the Volus, so they sold the colonization rights to their Turian partners. Omakur's spaceports and major roads were blasted into craters by the Reapers, largely immobilizing the population. Its Turian defenders are slowly being pushed back by ground forces. Colony founded in 1153 CE. Population is 259,200,000. Pre-invasion. Capital is Sarlacc. Let's check out the, you know, this. Asteroid belt. Okay. Got a Saturn-like gas giant here. Whelm-Urin is a hydrogen-helium gas giant. The phrase Whelm-Urin in the Volus native language translates to the Golden One, a reference to its deep yellow-orange rings. Much to prospectors' dismay, there was no gold to be found in its moons. Whelm-Urin's economic contribution to the system was the ubiquitous helium-3, but the collection materials have since been destroyed by the Reapers. Jeez. Bunch of stinkers. And finally, Gorgon. Like Whelm-Urin, Gorgon was a hydrogen-helium gas giant whose helium-3 infrastructure was destroyed by the Reapers. Not much to say there. Kinda wanna look for something before. It's not in the belt. Just wanna see if there's anything here before we start scanning and alerting Reapers. Nothing close to here, no. Maybe something down here somewhere. Maybe not. Okay. Let's plant ourselves here and we'll...
I found something.
Found something. Probe launched. Volus Intelligent Archives. Cool. Question mark around that one. 50%. Alright, so both these planets were covered, so it's either something here, something in the space that I haven't found. Alright. Okay, wait. We got space for one more. The only problem is...
Evasion successful.
We're gonna have to come back to Nura next time. Can we make it to Asori? Yes. If we don't find any fuel here, we're gonna have to head back and fuel up somewhere else. Mola. For a terrestrial planet, Mola hurtles around the system's star at breakneck speed. Its rapid orbit and molten core cause oceans of magma to be pumped out onto the surface, cooling into continent-sized formations, then erased by fresh flows of molten rock. Doesn't sound like a good place to live. Aethon-Urin. The most interesting names of Volus. Aethon-Urin was claimed, along with the rest of its system, after the Volus learned FTL travel. In the great Volus exploration push of 300 BCE, the species found only a few planets capable of supporting their colonies. They did, however, discover many planets teeming with valuable elements. The orbiting robo-mining platforms of Aethon-Urin have since been shot through by the Reapers. Little remains except the occasional bit of space debris posing a navigation hazard. Yeah, they're being really systematic here, aren't they? Yan Tao. Even by Volus standards, the pressure on Yan Tao is crushing. With an atmosphere composed of carbon dioxide, argon, and small traces of oxygen, the surface is devoid of life. However, tiny fossilized sea creatures have been discovered in the deepest crevices of what used to be Yan Tao's oceans. Really? 133 Earth atmospheres. Oh, gravity's not bad, it's just the atmospheric pressure. Kalo. Kalo's frigid surface is dotted with impact craters left during a legendary meteor shower that happened more than 400,000 years ago. The meteors contain traces of cobalt, but not enough to warrant a full-scale mining expedition. The Volus have largely left Kalo alone, as have the Reapers. Well, at least they spared something. Solu Paolis. Solu Paolis' Helium-3 collection mechanisms historically turned a large profit, not because of any great immigration into the Asari system, but because Solu Paolis made a good refueling stop between Arun and Satu Ard. Warned of the Reapers' battle plans, but left with little other option, a select team of workers at Solu Paolis sent out phony communications suggesting that important military data was being handed off there. When the Reapers sent in a force of husks, they ran into the Volus' trap, a chain reaction that annihilated the station. That's awesome. That's actually really clever. I like that. Anyway. Should I fly around trying to find something? I don't want to leave every system partially explored. I hate that. Or, you know, assets partially discovered. Boop. So after this we have the N7 Cerberus, more Cerberus fighting. There's a lot of that in this game. I guess because we're not fighting, you know, the Mercs, because they're on our side, so who else is there left to fight, right? In the last game we were fighting, like, Blood Pack, Eclipse Mercs, Blue Suns. We're not even fighting Geth anymore. The only one left to fight is Cerberus and the Reaper forces. I couldn't find anything, so. Crap. Can we escape through the bottom of the system? Try this planet. Nope, I guess we're gone. Yeah.
Reapers eluded.
Couldn't find anything there. We need to head back for the mass relay and wait here. Duh. Oh sheesh. Oh right, crap. Where's the mass relay? No, keep going. Every once in a while it stops. Can I go in this? Wait. This side? Can't
evasion
risk it.
Successful.
Oh! I went back out.
Faster than light jump successful.
Thank you. I think this is where I've been going to fuel up the Cerberus fighter base. Horsehead Nebula. Naturally, I'm just going to fuel up so I can get to that. Yeah, see, there it is. So I can get to that last system. Of course, we're going to have to evade Reapers. He was so low on fuel. I don't think we've ever been that low. Crazy. Because I wasn't finding any fuel, damn it, to help me get to the next one. Where was it? Yeah. Now I gotta leave the system right away.
Evasion successful.
Okay, we need to head all the way down to this Satu Ard. Trying to coast there. Hope we find some fuel here. That'd be nice to get back. Three planets. Polo Tem. This world is believed to be an extrasolar capture that built up its atmosphere over millions of years to become the hothouse it is today. Volus robo-miners descended on Polo Tem when Element Zero was first discovered there, and in turn, pirates descended on the Volus. The pirates then found out, to their detriment, that wealthy Volus can buy a lot of influence in the Turian hierarchy. The Reapers occupied Polo Tem's orbital stations rather than destroy them outright. It is possible that Element Zero is rare enough that the Reapers harvest it, but it is more likely that the Reapers are stationing ships here in case the Turian forces they drove off seek to recapture it. Rillar. Rillar is a barren terrestrial rock world. Only a small portion of the planet has been explored, as cursory scans showed little of interest on Rillar compared to the Ezo deposits on the neighboring world of Polo Tem. The planet appears not to have garnered Reaper attention, which would make it a good rendezvous point for any scattered organic force needing to discharge their drive cores. Cool. Now listen. A lonely world of rock and ice, Nalissan clings to the outer rim of the Satu Ard system. Its freezing temperatures and carbon dioxide atmosphere were braved by Ezo smugglers who set up camps in the tunnels, honeycombing the southern hemisphere's mountain ranges. The camps were abandoned when Turian patrols began regular raids on the smugglers' cave systems. Okay, this is really spaced apart. So we're only going to be able to scan one planet at a time. I hope we find something here. I'd like to at least complete this system. Well, there were four, so then we'd have two out of four done. And we'll come back here, I guess, after the Cerberus mission. Because once you complete a quest, it resets. I don't know if it has to be a main... Hear something? No. I don't know if it has to be a main quest or just a side thing like this one. It would be nice though. I hear that.
Signal confirmed.
Good God. 200 units of fuel. Yay. Alright. So we can escape this way. Let's scan the two worlds. Here. And here. Nope, I guess we're done.
Reapers
damn it.
Polluted.
So annoying. So I just peek inside. If I come from this way. There's something there. But there's so many right there. Can I do it? I don't know why I'm... Probe launched. Let's see if I can get the hell away. We're close to the edge. Volus engineering team, but...
Evasion successful.
100% for that one. Yes! At least we got that one. We'll come back at a later time and do these guys. I can't find anything in this one. We need one more here. Crap-a-roleo.
Reapers eluded.
Intercepting me, damn it. Almost out of fuel, too. Still.
Faster than light jump successful.
Hell to the air. Whew. Pretty hairy. Spending a lot of money on fuel lately. Right, so I already have this. I have to go to Citadel and drop it off somewhere. I still don't know where that is. We have to return to Barlavan. I still haven't found that, and I have found this. Return it to him in the Presidium Commons. Yeah, a little bit of a shorter episode, guys, but it's weird to start off now with the mission. The Cerberus attack mission on Novaria. We're going to be doing that next episode, and then after that, heading to the Citadel, because there's nothing really else to do that I know of. So, thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.